This is fucking Birdhouse the End, one of the best fucking videos to ever come out. Tony Hawk's in it, Andrew Reynolds in it, Keith Pritchard's in it, Steve Barra's in it. It's a fucking amazing video. We've got porn stars in the video. We've got $100 bills on fire in the video.
Monkeys.
We've got monkeys. We've got El Toro. Everything you could fucking want is in this video, so we're gonna play it right now.
Toadhouse, the fence, the hen.
Remember those? Those were like artifacts. Do people still use those?
Yeah, some people do to get their
like
paper.
A quarter to get a paper. Is that McCrank?
Look at this. Yeah, Rick McCrank, dude.
Honestly, like one of the most underrated skateboarders of all.
Skateboarder wanted. Team Birdhouse team member needed. EP by Tony Hawk and Parawellender. This is fucking golden age.
I like how back in the day, skateboarding videos actually had like almost like little subplots or like introductory. There'd be like introductions to each part.
Oh, dude.
You know what I mean? Like nowadays, it's you don't have that. It's straight to skateboarding. Wow.
This video is so fucking sick.
Okay, so which one is he?
Oh, we're gonna have a hard time.
I'm assuming that's Nolly, yeah. Which make that switch.
You don't, you just can.
Damn, Rick, let's go.
Rick McCrank's.
Is this film?
Canadian legend.
This has to be film.
This was all
that was
shot
gorgeous.
With film. Cost $1 million to make this in 2000, so that's like 99, so that's like 2 million or 3 million today.
Dude.
Like 2 million to make a skate film. This video's next level. Shot on film.
98. He's 50180 on a 10 stair. Back lip? What?
He's just. You don't have to act to pretend to be like fake impressed. I get it. Like, it's not as good as this. But he's sick. I love him. Right?
No, but what I'm trying to say is like, it's the same exact level as today.
Yeah. I mean, this rail's massive.
That, does he, what's he do?
It's just you.
Are you serious?
Bang on.
That was. That would be like a Thrasher cover today.
Bang.
I'm not gonna lie, I haven't seen this in literally 20 years.
It's been a while for me too.
And it's not like one of the ones that I like religiously watch. Did you religiously watch this one?
No, I didn't.
Yeah, me either.
I mean, I watched it like a good deal of times, but
yeah.
Nothing like the flip video.
Yeah, it's not like Modus Operandi.
Yeah.
Like that one I've seen literally 100 times.
See, we've got a title sequence. This is almost like foreshadowing for when Rick McCrank gets down in the airport.
What was that we just saw? Was that like an intro part?
Yeah, intro into Wahoo Fish Tacos, Birdhouse the End.
I'm extremely excited about this. Is that the same committee? It is.
This is right by my house.
That's right by my house.
The food fight.
That's San Clemente. Wow. That is awesome.
In slow motion.
Film, man. So good.
It was a clear black night, a clear white moon. G was on the streets.
God, everything about that.
Some skirts for so I can get some fun. Flip that nose, try no problem.
Where is that spot? The east side of the LBC.
My mission trying to find Mr. Solid. Seen a car full of girls, ain't no need to tweak. I can't believe they shot a skate video on film. Are they stupid?
Was digital like a thing in 98?
It just didn't look this good.
I feel like this looks great.
Well, it's because it's shot on film. There's no pixels.
Yeah. Weird.
I mean, if you wanted the best quality skating, you were going to shoot it on film.
Sure. But I'm like that. See, if that took him 40 tries.
Exactly. They were wasting so much money making this thing. And they all around. They wanna come up real quick before they start the clown. Can you imagine trying to film a skate video on film right now? You would go broke. Well, this was, I mean, just also in an era where, like, you know, all eyes were on one video.
Yeah, right.
And you know, Birdhouse skateboards, I remember, like, I lived in the middle of nowhere, and for some reason, the word on the street was that Birdhouse makes the best skateboards. So you better, and if you're a little kid, you're dumb, so you don't know anything. So you're like, oh, I need to get a Birdhouse skateboard because Tony Hawk and the Birdhouse team are the best. So you literally think that buying a Birdhouse board is going to make you, like, better at skating.
Oh, that's so gnarly. Landing into a thing like that.
I mean, just hype runs wild, you know?
You know, nobody sets up binges up anymore like that. Let's bring that back.
How many frames per second were they running this film at? So that's wasting even more money.
Right.
Multiple angles too. I say wasting.
I mean,
because I
is.
Feel like filming skateboarding is such, like, a frivolous thing, but
kind of.
I think I'm just remembering this video differently. I felt like they mixed some digi in there, but I'm just seeing all film.
This is
all the way through.
How about Willie Santos?
How about Willie Santos?
What's he doing nowadays? Dude, the quality of this is so much better than the
other skate videos we were watching.
Yeah.
I know exactly. They just went wild with this video. I mean, this will never be done again. Nobody's ever gonna throw $1 million for a film skate video.
I agree.
Doesn't matter how good your frontside flip is, they're not gonna pay for it.
Dude, that frontside flip is a fucking piece of art. Dude, look at the streets. Look at how clean they look. You see that?
A while ago.
Yeah. 98 Hollywood, or 98 downtown LA.
That was, yeah, Hollywood High. Things are a little different.
A little different. I think that's my favorite trick.
Never forget that part. That's kind of corny.
God, he is so young. 98? What's he like? 18? 21?
Has Stella seen this?
Probably. Watch Dad's old footage.
Be like, yeah, Dad was better than you're ever gonna be, so.
Yeah, don't try to live up to his expectations.
Yeah, just joking.
He's got like the mushroom top with the big old hair.
Oh yeah, dude, just put a bowl up there and just start trimming. That's how you do it. Here we go, ready? You ready? Give it a minute. It's about to get wild. This is the buildup.
You know, he does have a really good varial heel. This
oh yeah.
I
damn I'm, huge sets.
Obviously I like his front side flip more, but his varial heel is also something that is a piece of art. Yeah.
Kickflip nose.
I don't even know what that would ever feel like. I will never think about
what a kickflip nose block
what that feels like.
If you put the work in, maybe you'll get it. Probably not down
the
bench.
You ever done a kickflip nose slide?
No, never a kickflip nose one, no. I've done like some nose blunts, but.
No, kickflip nose slide?
Oh yeah, kickflip nose slide, yeah, but that's like a lame trick.
It's one of those tricks that
nose slides are like cheater tricks.
Dude, kickflip board slide on there?
You ready?
so good. Oh my god.
This is us right now.
Straight up.
The trailer park with the monkey, dude.
We are the drunk monkey.
Skate video, good.
Good.
More beer?
More beer? Good.
Go to Skate. Fred's Liquor for more beer.
Do a better hard flip, man.
He's not a big hard flipper, Ryan Reynolds. Look, they even bored out the Budweiser. They went through that much effort. Oh, probably on the DVD. I don't think they did blurt it out before. I don't remember ever seeing blurs on shit.
I don't.
Maybe I just was never paying attention. I don't know.
Yeah, I don't remember it being blurred out.
I hope that I can someday make a film and not blur anything and have people try to sue me and then just laugh in my face because they're idiots. Seriously, stop blurring stuff. You don't have the right to make me blur something.
They didn't blur the JV.
Because JV is down with the cause.
Yes. Look at this skit.
Before Murdy the dog, you had Marvin the monkey.
Straight up.
You got jacked.
You all right?
Dude, I remember Brian Sumner came to Seattle during the Tony Hawk tour.
Mm-hmm.
Killed it.
That's big.
Isn't Brian Sumner like a Christian?
I don't know.
I think he does like church skate camp things. Kind of smart, get like a church to pay for your skate park.
Yeah, you know what I want to do with my life is convert churches into skate parks.
Oh, just like big cathedrals and stuff, uh-huh. Put skate parks inside them?
Uh-huh.
They actually did one of those. You should watch the Vice series with Rick McCrank. He goes to a cathedral that has a ramp in it.
Oh.
Rick McCrank actually has a really good Vice series.
It's
like traveling around and skating weird spots.
Cool.
God, I've never even heard of this dude.
Allie?
Yeah, he like wasn't on the radar too much for me. Seems pretty good. Poor Baker. Just a little bit blowing down.
I know this name. Jeff Lavois. He's in the industry. Whoa!
Oh, you mean like not as skating anymore? He does like other shit now.
Yeah. He's a behind the scenes.
He's the man behind the curtain now.
He's got like...
He's good.
He's got pop.
Look at that. Nollie like, heel,
everything,
man.
Everything that he does
He's always
up.
Been really good. Like over fence stuff. Like you had Drew filming you and shit. On the bootleg angle that wasn't used because this is all film. This explains a lot.
Audio shirt.
Didn't know that he was in like some like sitcom type, or not sitcom, but like some like teen drama type thing and he gets hit by a bus.
Steve Bear?
Yeah, have you seen that footage?
Uh-uh.
Oh, I'm gonna have to show that to you. He was an actor too.
Mm.
So this is his greatest performance in my opinion though. I love Steve Bear. You let me in the barracks if I say that?
No.
In sports, the Blue Jays and the Yankees meet tonight in the deciding game.
God, I love the cheap porno feel of this.
It's got...
Cheap porno.
It's got vibes.
Written all over it. Cheap porno vibes?
Yeah.
On film, I love it. And he wakes up and the pizza's here. Have you ever cried during skating? Because you're frustrated? I don't think I have either. Bear will challenge you.
Dude, that's a...
He's good.
That's Buck.
I know. dude, he's Buck. He's good.
But I don't like the whole Scientology thing.
I don't give a fuck about Scientology because, in my opinion, like...
Wait, you're cool with people believing in lies?
I mean, I'm cool with Christianity. I'm cool with, you know, Mormons. I'm cool with, you know... I'm not really cool with Muslims. Whoops!
I mean, what's... Why do you... Why is it okay to...
I'm joking.
Well, I mean...
I don't really give a fuck about religion. I think that people that are involved with religion, I think it's probably like a... an essential thing to make people settle the fuck down. Because if you haven't noticed in the streets recently that, like, a good number of people are just fucking animals, and that, like, religion gets people to chill the fuck out because they think God's real or something.
Well, it's a... Everybody agrees on something that's make-believe.
Well, they...
That's how religion
They
works.
Agree on a code of conduct.
Sure.
But, you know...
It's also a general understanding that we all believe in something that is not real.
It's joining... People are tribal, and it's yeah. saying, hey, everybody join the same tribe and let's not fight. That's what a religion is. Because, quite honestly...
But shouldn't we just do that as humans in general?
You would think it would be that easy, but it's not. I think it actually is really easy, and everyone is doing it except for the media that's blowing shit out of proportion. Like,
yeah.
Everybody gets along except for the media and yeah. Twitter that wants to, like, blow shit up. Are we watching Skateboarding, or are we... What are we doing?
I'm not seeing much Skateboarding, so...
Okay.
Let me know when it starts.
No, I was just talking more so about us. I can deal with the little mini double kink dramatic intro. I like it. I love you, Steve Barron.
Dramatic is a term.
Hey, if I could be in a TV show, I'd be a Scientologist. If you could cast in something, would you be turn Scientologist? If you could have the barracks right now all to yourself and become a Scientologist, I would right away. I would be like, Xenu, nolly back heel.
Over the head.
Dude, I'd be worshiping, every night I would worship Xenu if I got to fucking skate the barracks all the time, dude. Or if I could kickflip back 50 rail, he got that power from Xenu. Don't think that didn't come from Xenu, man.
Well, it didn't come from Xenu because he wasn't in
Scientology. He wasn't a Scientologist
yet. This time.
Well, Xenu was just gifting him with the gift and ability and power,
before
knowing that one
him.
Day he would
yeah.
find the true master.
Cool. Lucky him. If only we could all meet Xenu.
I love Xenu. I'm gonna, maybe, I don't want to, like, say anything, but, like...
Say it.
I mean, at least from this footage, he seems, like, really... Well, I guess it's a skit, so the whole idea is that it's acting. I get it. Remember, we're watching a skate video.
Yeah, also remember, he...
Wasting so much money. How much money did they decide to waste on this?
What did we just watch?
Dude.
He was skateboarding, he had bad dreams, and then...
Remember when he had to go in a porta potty with a porno?
But what was the skit? That skit didn't even make sense.
He just got his head chopped off.
Just randomly?
Dude, Jeremy Klein and Keith Burchard.
Yeah.
This is what I remember about the end.
Yeah.
Fucking band, dude.
Manual pad on top. It didn't even look like a front wheel was going. Look at that wall.
Absolutely ridiculous. Can you hear that? Over cones and shit. It's on fire.
How is that? That's low-key epic. Just really.
This is El Toro. They literally broke through the gates.
This like goes down the fucking skate history right here. Broke through the gates to lip slide El Toro when it was still skatable. Dude, in slow motion on film, are you fucking kidding me? This is the best part, best trick in the film. Took the man down El Toro. Just fucking on fire, just cruising down the highway.
Best trick on El Toro, the van.
Just skating up to all the spots with the fucking van on fire.
Oh my god.
Over the car, dude.
Oh, he couldn't get through it.
Look how much money they wasted on this skate video. They got like Hollywood stunt people and shit.
That's pretty epic. That was a really weird explosion. That was crazy.
The end is the strangest thing. As far as skate videos go, mwah. After a long day of skating, look what you have waiting for you.
There hasn't been much skateboarding in the last.
Oh, this is the best part.
Was that Steve Bear's part?
I guess.
Like four tricks?
He had a solid part.
Huh?
He had a solid amount of skating.
He had maybe 10 tricks.
No, he had more, but no.
What?
Isn't this just amazing?
Did we watch the same thing?
Just like young delinquents with porn stars?
Yeah. That's what it's all about.
This is what happens when you're a professional skateboarder. They pick up your dry cleaning and your skateboard with their tits out.
Yeah. I mean, and when I was 18, this was exactly what I wanted in my life.
Since this is the extended version, do we get to see all that has transpired?
The extended
version? Or the extended cut? Bigger, longer, and uncut. Snickers, Reese's, and Butterfinger.
How about a with blue drink?
Absinthe, yeah. Or no, I mean absinthe is green, I guess, but whatever the hell that is.
Hot tub with a collared shirt on.
With the shirt on in the hot tub. I'm telling you, bring the full length film skate video back. Bring this shit back.
Dude, that's gonna be a passion project that you're gonna pursue and get it dialed in.
Just waste $2 million?
Yeah, also, Butterfingers are the absolute worst.
Get it? She's opening it with her teeth.
Because she doesn't.
Oh, look how long that is.
Oh, she went there. She did that. Now, bite my chuck.
I don't think he had to really bite it. He needed to make it skip that part.
That's not my style. I'm
after a long day of skating, we've got the fireplace. Oh, the Nintendo 64. So this is the life, man.
Is that the gold version?
Switch.
Goldeneye, dude.
Yeah. Pyramid.
Dude, this is the life.
What was that? That level?
I don't remember, man. It's been so long. They put your trucks together for you? Put your board together? At least just put the trucks on, right?
Remember Blockbusters?
Yeah.
This is amazing right here.
Registered trademark.
This is hard.
Mr. Heath Corchard.
Mr. Heath Corchard.
He also got the money symbol. How about...
Ate shit so bad.
How about... I'm holding on to that kickboard.
No, off the...
Wow.
The green screen ramp that I don't think they were ever able to clean out. They did all these green screen... I think it was before the time of, like, actually being able to do the Yeah Right. I think they probably tried and it did not work.
You think that's why it's green?
I think so. Like, why the fuck would you paint a ramp green? I think they were trying to edit it out to make it look like, you know... And I think they just failed. That's my guess. Because it's really hard to throw those stuff out, and it's really expensive, too. Like, not easy to make a ramp here.
People should...
What they did in Yeah Right was fucking impressive.
People should... Yes!
That's insane. I love the launchy ramp.
Dude, why are not more people
bringing ramp places?
Bringing ramp places.
Because they're not skating in suits and they're not, like... millionaire playboys.
That's epic.
The best part about this whole thing is that they're skating in suits the entire time.
Right.
Like, they didn't stop with the suit thing. I know.
He just
that's
fucking
some Tony
grinded Ackford. All this.
Exactly.
On top of a bus stop.
It's not, that wasn't supposed to happen ever.
Yeah, none of that manufacturing was.
It's just wild.
I don't remember this being so epic.
Oh, I remember it.
It was epic, but it wasn't like. I guess it's just because we're watching it like really. Essentially 20 years later.
Yeah.
And there's more context. Everything now?
Gas, $1.19 a gallon. You like that shit?
$1.19.
They're just getting wasted in
this fucking bottle of dick.
This is what happens when you go all out on a skate video. On fire, let's fly. Double.
He fucked up and it was film.
Yeah.
Like, it's one of those things where it's like, look, we got one go.
Pretty much.
And he almost didn't even make it to the end.
Yeah.
Crazy.
Yeah.
You gotta clean your pool when you're a multimillionaire answering your cell phone.
Hello. Hello.
Yeah.
Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Hello. Riley Hawk. You know, if there's, like, one person that, you know, like, living in the shadows of a parrot has got to be really hard. But I feel like Riley Hawk is such a, like, down-to-earth human being for having a dad who's literally the most famous person in skateboarding.
His shirt says, I'm a piece of shit, I'm number two or something. He's doing his wife's, like... pedicure. They blurred out shit too.
Yeah, of course.
This is really the DVD version that I've got on my hands. This is not the original.
The true DVD.
Hey, dogs love me 'cause I'm crazy, sniffle. Oh, somebody was saying that, like, because this video was shot on film, that you could remaster it to 4K Blu-ray right now. Because it's shot on film.
Oh.
You can make it look even better today.
I believe that. I mean,
just rescan the negative.
Yeah, I believe that, yeah.
He's signing all the autographs and shit.
You know, actually, the corporations that, you know, they were trying to blur out, actually aren't benefiting as much as they could be by allowing their products in these videos.
I think the whole boring thing is just a weird, like, legal Tony Hawk's life misunderstanding.
I need my board.
Number one, Bucky. Number two.
Kind of sounds like a White Stripes song. I'm going to Wicked Town.
Oh. Dude, he's also skating brand new boards. You see that shit?
Yeah.
Not a scratch on him.
Also, black wheels.
That one's definitely been skated, but...
Cannonball!
Remember when people, like, hated on Tony Hawk? Do you remember that?
It was very
so
short-lived.
Strange.
I mean,
people were so...
Well, because he was able to capitalize on skateboarding financially. That's why people...
Well, I just think people didn't... I think, you know, hermetic skateboarders didn't like the fact that grandma knew who he was.
Right.
I think that's all it came down to. It's like skateboarding is this secret club, and how come my teacher knows who Tony Hawk is? I don't like this.
Yeah, but... Yeah.
So you have no idea. And I don't skate vert ramps, so, like, you know, I skate street, so, like... I'm more like Andrew Reynolds. I'm more like Keith Kirchhoff. I'm more like Willie Sanders. I'm more like Garrett. I don't do this. You don't get me. I think that's what it came down to.
Yeah. You're either Bucky Lassig or you're Tony Hawk.
Yeah. The craziest thing about all these dudes is that they're still so good.
Still skating.
Like, a lot of street skaters are just done. They're out for the count. They don't skate. They just can't. Or, like, what they can do is just, like, not even worth showing.
Have you heard Tony Hawk's argument about why vert skating is actually way more fun to watch?
No, what's his argument?
Every single wall you hit, there's another trick.
Exactly.
And whereas, like, if you skate, like nowadays, you have, like...
They, like, barely land anything.
Yeah, if you have, like...
They barely land anything.
If you have, like, a park, which is part of the contest series, there's a park, right? And
yeah.
So there'll be 10 seconds where they're pushing or turning around through a bowl before you see another trick. Whereas as a half pipe, every other second, you're seeing a new trick.
I would just...
Oh, that's cool.
I know. Well, I would just...
What the hell
say,
is that?
I don't see. The problem is that I'm so removed from Bert, I can't... I don't know what to tell you. But I think that, like, with... And they went to, you know, fucking build the... This is why...
$19.98. I can tell that was big.
Yeah. They built this...
Film looks good, man.
Well, no, they built this ramp just for him for this video. Isn't that insane?
I mean, yes, but also no. He was the best vert skater at the time. Wow. Slow-mo vert actually kind of feels better than... regular speed.
Dude.
That's
dude, insane.
You know Danny Way's coming out of the new park?
You're gonna have to watch it.
Drum roll, please.
Dude.
You know what's strange and sad though is that like vert, apparently the actual like act of vert skating where it's just two walls and it's not the stupid mega ramp shit is like going away.
Yeah, for sure.
And it shouldn't, because it's way more impressive to me than the mega ramp shit. The consistency, the back...
The consistency is where
the
it's
runs,
at.
Dude, yeah. The runs. It's like, I don't need to see one big launch and then hitting, you know, hitting a wall. It's like, I fucking get it.
Well, it's like, the reason why mega ramp is so popular, and it's not popular at all, except to a very few. That was epic. But the reason it's popular is because every single time that person goes up in the air, he could die. That's what we're watching. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, we're watching to see if something really happens, you know, other than what's planned.
He's got his bird.
That's a weird... I've never seen that type of bird.
Die bird.
Yeah. Oh, die bird.
He's like an evil villain.
Cell phone.
I mean, that's when life was better. No Instagram on that shit.
Seriously. Snake was the game.
If you were lucky enough to have Snake.
Straight up.
A lot of phones had nothing. Yeah, he got the loop. It's the 9 that he didn't get, but he spins one. He gets close.
I really don't like watching a bull get stabbed.
Cheap porno.
I'm the shit.
Now he's number one.
Yes.
He blew up Tony Hawk. He's got a sports car for it.
Shove, grab, tail.
Yeah.
What?
But I think probably the most
I like the tail grab.
The most ridiculous vert skater out there is probably Bob Burnquist. As far as tech switch,
I would say tech goes to Bucky Lassen. I think switch goes to Bob Burnquist.
We're close enough to this ramp. We should just go to this and learn how to skateboard right now.
Nike, back in 98.
They tried. They were trying so hard. They were failing. They were not getting anywhere in skateboarding. Everyone fucking hated Nike. But they tried. They were still trying. They were the little engine that could back then. Nobody would buy Nike to skate that shit. Everyone fucking hated that shit.
Yep.
But they would love to rewrite history and pretend like they had anything to do with skateboarding.
I just love that they did that bit with Willie Santos at the... What's the taco place called?
Wahoos?
Wahoos. In San Clemente. You know,
go ahead.
You're gonna get rid of the middle finger. Like, the level of offensiveness that everybody is getting offended, the, le- level of everybody's getting offended, the like middle finger will no longer be offended.
I'm offended.
By 2030.
I'm offended.
Exactly. By 2030, you won't even be able to use the middle finger. It'll be offensive to people that don't have middle fingers.
I am sorry.
I can't.
And I really mean that, baby.
I can't believe.
The end.
I can't believe where skateboarding is and where it was. I have so many feelings.
Looking at extras, man. I've never, obviously never gone in here.
Ooh,
making it again. Long, kind of.
Is this the first loop?
I think that was the first loop that was ever done, but I could be wrong. I'm pretty sure it was the first loop. God, Pritchard's such a beast.
He is a beast.
Did you hear about him, the sailing thing, or the paddling, the boat thing that he did? He was out on the, like, the coast and like almost died and stuff. He's just like paddling a boat.
Yeah. This really is the movie that laid the foundation for skateboarding.
I mean, some people would say like the Powell videos and shit, but fuck
yeah,
Powell.
But yes, I know what you mean. And I agree. I think those have a certain
I mean, this place. Been a long time, and we always had been known to have one of the best teams, so we had a lot to live up to, so we
he's got like
decided we'd do something really special and
big
commit Nick. A lot to it. Mouse called me up and said we should get together and talk about doing a Birdhouse video.
Be all right.
I have some ideas.
I met with Pear one day for lunch and just kind of went over some ideas and, you know, making sure everybody was going to be pretty committed and motivated to just working on that.
Sign here, you're not going to make anything. And you
one thing
I
wanted to accomplish with the end was to make a skateboard video that was more entertaining and crazier than ever before.
And entertainment we got.
I mean, they made their money back tenfold.
We got facts from Switzerland that explains that they found it was offensive to mankind.
Banned in Switzerland. Here we go.
He called me up and said we should shoot in film for the first time in a long time that anything's been shot in film for skateboard videos.
Most skateboard videos you see today are shot on digital videotape. One of the major differences in the end is that it was shot on film. The difference in price from video to film is an hour of videotape cost about $10 and an hour of film cost about $2,000.
Yep.
Yeah, well, it's about 10 times or 20 times more expensive than digital or any type of tape.
This was 98!
So, I got really nervous when I started counting the feet that Mouse ended up using.
It takes about 5 feet of film to shoot a skateboard trick at a cost of about $1 a foot. Some tricks take, you know, 20, 30, 40 attempts. And at $5 a pop, that's a lot of money.
Bills, 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 bills.
We ended up committing more than we should have, but it turned out good.
It took quite a while to make the end. It took a total of about 13 months. If you can imagine all these skaters slamming, it hurts. They need to rest for some cases.
13 months? That's nothing.
No, I know.
So it takes quite a long time.
Between injuries, security guards, cops, and busted up skate spots, it took about 160 days.
Six broken bones? They were going for broke, man. That's a lot of broken bones. A broken bone's nothing to fuck with.
How you doing tonight, Janelle?
Good evening, Mr. Santos. It's so nice to see you again.
Really skates real smooth, real technical.
So how's the kickflip nose blend fly coming?
Come across to no cigar.
Willie has an amazing natural ability.
Look at those computers!
I love it.
To the jacuzzi?
Sure.
All right, let's go.
A lot of girls have been coming up to me and
getting autographs and wanted to hang out. The hardest tricks in my part were doing a lip slide, doing it in between the ledge and the rail, and the kickflip into Poway Banks.
I knew that was tough. So that's gnarly.
It's so weird because these guys are like younger than us.
Then.
Yeah.
Food fight was real cool. We got to go to Wahoo's Tacos and get a whole bunch of free food. And we pretended like there was this meeting and stuff. And Tony kind of got up and started giving a speech.
The food fight, that was lame. It burnt my eyes. I knew it was coming. Tony purposely sat right next to me. And you know, you could tell like with all those big bowls, something's gonna happen.
About 15 or 20 seconds, I didn't know what was going on. Willie was just getting covered with beans and salsa and chips, and people were throwing cups, and I think Heath and them were throwing plates and glasses and stuff.
He's the coolest. I mean, we were filming one time right after we had filmed a big scene with him. I get pulled over by the cops, you know, and they start asking me all about all these stickers and stuff all over my car. I told them we were just, you know, filming a scene for Birdhouse with Willie Santos. Well, the policeman knew Willie, and he asked me some questions, and I gave him the right answers, and we walked away right out of there, man. I was just, oh man, I couldn't believe it.
That's awesome.
Andrew is the one guy in the film who pretty much led the pack. He was the first guy to really get going in the film, like first guy to really throw down some big stuff and get everybody pretty psyched up on trying to keep up the pace.
For a skate, my favorite part would be Andrews.
Everybody's favorite
part. That was a weird push, but no big deal.
I gave Jay a movie camera for the first time and he ended up getting one of Andrew's best tricks.
Andrew's frontside blunt kickflip out on San Marcos. You know, that was the first thing I ever filmed on 16. It's not the best filming, but it was just awesome seeing it live.
That is
gnarly. Most of the other guys would try tricks 30, 40, 50 times, and Andrew was the one guy on the crew that actually pulled a lot of his tricks within the first few tries.
Saving money.
Yeah.
It's a good return on investment.
Two attempts?
Part is as big and technical as it gets in skateboarding. We filmed the monkey scene at my friend Gene Savay's house. He had a trailer in the back that pretty much resembled Andrew's home back in Lakeland, Florida. So it was a perfect set for shooting Andrew's scene. We got to hire Clint Eastwood's monkey, Claude, and I think he cost like $2,500 for the day. And the monkey did a real good job, pretty much didn't take too many tries for him to do what, you know, what we were asking him. The trainers were pretty rough with him, actually kind of yelling. Sometimes he'd grab somebody's
him,
arm
dude.
Or finger or something
Tiger
like
King.
That.
It was even one instance where we were filming
it,
and it was kind of
looked like
time
it.
To get the
yeah.
Shot or whatever. Nah. The monkey got a little agitated. And,
wow, nice job on you for seeing that.
Like, try to bite his leg and he got kind of scared. But other than that, it went pretty smooth.
That was crazy.
Originally, my part was going to be with Jeremy and Heath. They bought these $1,200 suits, and I kind of wimped out in buying a $1,200 suit to go skating in because I didn't want to ruin it for some reason. They got kind of fed up, so finally they met me down at Birdhouse and kind of gave me the boot.
Gave him the what?
He didn't want to skate in his suit or something?
This one night, I went to do this trick, and it was really late at night. So I'm like killing myself for this thing. My back's bleeding, I got a hole in my shirt, I can barely walk. I finally pull the trick, and then I'm like, you know, pretty psyched. And he says to film me, it was eating in the camera. I have to go back 5 more times after that to actually do it. There's a whole
solid,
part
dude.
Where I'm throwing my board, you know.
I did like that kickflip, that clip.
That part was just how bonus mouse footage that he got when I was getting mad trying to do stuff. In the beginning of the video, it's all just acting.
What is that cherry
for dramatic effect for the beginning of the part? I was trying to think of how to do my skate. All these people have different ideas of what my part actually means. But it was just because I was friends with Howard and I wanted to get my head cut off.
Look at this chair.
This is called alginate. It's a dental material. And what we did is we had Steve sit there and we put a ball cap on his hair and we mixed this goop up and put it all over his face and it set up like in 4 minutes and then backed it with these plaster bandages and we ended up with a negative impression of Steve's face. And then from there we poured clay into it and then we had a clay head of Steve and re-sculpted it and, you know, made it look real and molded it from there. I had a big fire extinguisher and I emptied it out and I filled it up with fake blood and hooked all these tubes into this upper torso that we built. You know, on cue the head went off, we hit it and just this fountain of blood just, you know, I mean, it was like more blood than would be in a real person's body. But that's what was cool about it.
Because then, remember, it was like strapped to
my
back.
Oh yeah, then we did that, that's right.
And I leaned over like this, and when the head popped, you know, and I fell down.
Oh, that's like an execution chair.
Yeah. We just kind of taped on the shoulder and neck stump onto Steve, but still hooked it up to the blood.
Some weird shit.
So if you shoot from behind, you know, you don't really see Steve's head because he's ducking down.
My son saw that thing. Man, his head's coming off. He was actually scared.
When it was time to film Jeremy Klein and Heath Kirchhart's part, there were some stunts involving fire, and I couldn't be responsible really for the safety issues and filming the parts at the same time. So I hired George Phillips, who's a pyrotechnics expert.
Hi, my name's George Phillips. I'm a special effects coordinator in the movie industry.
We don't even fucking need George, man. We don't need a mouse. We can do that shit ourselves.
Jeremy has a tendency to like to pull things out of his hat and do them without even thinking about the consequences, without even going through any proper procedures of figuring out how to do them safely, how, you know, he was taking on and do it, whether it's safe or not.
Hey, we got a serious fire back here.
What's Jeremy Klein up to?
Yeah, there's a lot of people on the
Dude,
top,
I
man.
Know.
But Heath goes all the way over, man. He's just in a whole other
like
class all by himself. There's just nobody like that.
Heath is the guy who basically starts the worst trouble. He's the instigator of mayhem.
Listen, are you pissing me over?
That kind of behavior to me is immature and unresponsible.
Every time it gets to the part where they're going down the stairs and the van's on fire and going over bushes, I just want to crawl in a hole or something. It's really embarrassing to me.
It kept me real excited about working with
that's
them.
That's so get crazy.
Out. Get out, Gene.
Heath and Jeremy were the most enthusiastic assistants I've ever had. There's nothing in the way, nothing that makes them think twice about things. They drive like maniacs, they act like maniacs. When those guys are at the helm, just be prepared. Just put your safety belt on and get ready for a ride, because you're going to get one.
Jeremy's the worst driver. Jeremy should never drive.
Destroying property.
I just can't believe what he did.
Jeremy Klein and Heath Kirchhart probably were the most difficult skaters to work with because no one knew what they were doing. And we were all just a little apprehensive in handing over thousands of dollars in checks and not knowing what the hell it's going for.
They swore me to secrecy, basically, and Tony was the only guy I could, like, talk to.
I respected the fact that they didn't want anyone to know, so if I knew about something, I wouldn't tell, you know?
Had no idea. Had no idea. They just came with the bills, and the bills piled up. I mean, here are the bills, you know? It's a lot of bills.
They didn't know what
they
were shooting.
The girl scene was the first big shoot we did for the film.
Open up those pearly gates. We've made a big mistake.
It was myself, Kobe Ty, Janine, Heather Hunter, and Tia Bella, and it was a good group of girls. And the guys were so nice to us.
They have to be, right?
It's almost like they were little boys, like they were shy. They weren't quite sure if they were, you know, should say the right thing or if they should get close because they had to escort us, and I thought that was really sweet that they were being gentlemen.
Dude, the biggest problem about the whole thing is those girls wanted to leave the whole time. For sure.
Jeremy was so sweet.
Or Steve Vera.
Because I was in my bathing suit and that was it. Obviously, I wasn't naked. And he's like, trying to be all nonchalant, and it was cute.
I was very nervous when I was in the jacuzzi scene. I don't know if you can tell, but I look pretty ridiculous.
She's like, I wasn't naked
no,
like
I
usually
bathtub
am on
with
set.
This girl that I don't know. The water started out warm. We were in there for like an hour, so it ended up being like cold water, and it was just like an uncomfortable situation.
Yeah, it was real fun working with the girls. They were real professional, and they didn't need to be directed too much because they were already actresses, you know?
Actresses.
Okay, actresses. Okay. They're like, we know what to do.
I noticed that they were doing stuff on their own prior to me getting involved.
They were doing stuff on their own.
Shop and found out that they had a little shed out back that had burn marks all over it. Well, needless to say, I stopped them from doing that and said, this is the way we need to do it. And get the proper permitting, get the proper fire safety equipment standing by.
Getting mad at them for like just going for it?
Yeah.
And their pants catching on fire.
Normally when we do a film shoot like this or any kind of a shoot, we have a stuntman in place of the real performance doing the burn, not the real performance. It's always a stuntman. In this case, we're using the real performers.
I have 16, Av.
Yeah, 11 and a half.
We're 11. F11.
All right, you guys got to crouch. Everybody crouches.
Okay, oh my we're God. Rolling.
It's getting like up to their hair and stuff almost.
Is it Tony Hawk?
No. That's Jeremy Klein. So that was fish head.
You guys all right?
Jeremy wanted to reshoot the pier because he had slipped on the in run. And we ended up going back 3 weeks later. We did the reshoot. They both went off the jump ramp together. And it's funny because we ended up really going back and using the original shot from when Jeremy slipped. It was much more dramatic. It had a lot more feeling to it.
Oh, well, interesting.
I guess. I mean, I would have used
the most incredible part to me in the whole movie is Jeremy and Heath's night section. I don't know if it's because I put so many days of work
in. Did they not put the land in there?
60 nights from midnight till 6 in the morning.
They did. The Cape of 50 on the Blockbuster?
Okay.
My favorite shot in the night part was 60 nights of filming this. Cotton Shop, where Heath makes the 50-50 as the cop rolls into the frame of the camera. Jeremy and Heath got their boards taken away that night, but we got the shot. It was the one that they ended up not liking because you couldn't see Heath landing.
The high voltage box was the first place that we went to film at night. And when Jeremy did the backside lip slide on the high voltage box, that's when I knew this was going to be the most incredible segment. Like, from that point forward, it was just one thing after the next.
I dreaded going out on the night shoots because it was an all-night adventure with, you know, generator sound and gas fumes and the mayhem of Heath and Jeremy.
So it actually sucked.
That's basically what he was saying.
That's what it really sounded like at night.
That's crazy.
Mad nights on the street with Jeremy Klein and Heath Kirchhart, there's nothing that compares.
I'm Billy. Instagram's better.
Epic.
Oh, Skip Video's dead. I like Instagram.
It wasn't all about just trying brand new tech stuff like all the previous videos. I wanted mine to be more representative of everything that I had done in the past. Like some of the tricks that we got, I had done in other videos, but we'd never shot it with film and with Mouse's expertise. I had a whole list of tricks, like, and every time we go shoot, I'd just mark some off if we got them. And it really kind of represented where I had come in skating, like all the stuff that I had been doing.
With Tony's stuff, we always really wanted to shoot everything in super slow-mo. And I wanted to paint the whole room black so that when we lit the room, we were really gonna isolate Tony's skating so that
that was what I found kind of annoying.
No distractions. You know, it was a real good contrast from black to Tony.
We filmed
every day for about 3 to 4 weeks. And we got to the point where we wanted to step it up to the next level. Now that we had a foundation for Tony's part, we really wanted to step it up, and Tony had been talking about wanting to build a bigger ramp that he could do bigger tricks on and maybe some more technical stuff.
When I had the ramp in mind, the only crew I really wanted to do it was Team Payne, which is Tim Payne's crew, because he knows how to build ramps solid. He and his crew lived down there and built it, and they did an awesome job.
Oh my God.
and they wasted more money filming behind the scenes. God, they just wasted so much money on this.
You say waste, it's not a waste.
No, I know, but like...
With that ramp, we knew that there would be a height factor that I had never really experienced. I mean, Danny had done his DC ramp a while back, so we knew that bigger transitions would lend themselves
so
to
that was,
higher airs.
This was after.
And so when we built that one, it wasn't quite as big as that, because I still wanted it to be skatable in a half-pipe fashion.
Yep.
But really, just I wanted to do tricks that you never see at really big heights. And try a couple other things. Like I wanted, a few goals I had were definitely want to do varial 720, definitely want to do the loop, and I want to do 900. And other than that, all the other like kind of tech tricks I had in mind, we'd already done at the Birdhouse ramp. So, you know, we set out with not necessarily just those goals, but to try to get like, you know, like the stuff we did at big heights that haven't been done. It was like backside ollie, 540, stale fish in the air, stuff like that. You never really see it.
Agreed.
Above 10 feet.
It's like a live Hot Wheel track. It goes upside down and stuff. Kind of makes me nervous.
Basically, we got some pads down there, and with the help of Kevin and a few other guys, they would hold the pads up for the entry, and then as soon as we would pass, they would drop the pads, and then we'd usually fall into them. And then finally started getting the rhythm, and once I got the rhythm, we just took the pads out and shot it right away, because there wasn't any way to just stop and hang out for a while and then go back to it.
Oh, man. They had dolly setups and everything.
All right. Not fast enough. You gotta go over.
I can't do it right. I gotta go. Sit there, you know? Really, we just made a day of doing the loop. After I did it, we just kind of left for the day.
Yeah, I would be out of there.
Last day of filming, we decided that was gonna be 900 day, and so.
Birdhouse logo.
We had been shooting there for, you know, pretty much 6 days straight.
Birdhouse is
skating
sick.
All day, and I got really beat up.
Still is, man.
I really wanted to do it, but at the same time, I had a lot of
they have a dude,
working against me. Epic
squad.
Tony Hawk's game is coming out.
So I kept trying it, but I just couldn't convince.
Yeah, dude, that game is sick.
The last time I tried,
yeah, I don't play video games.
So I couldn't get that out of my mind.
Every skater
has
played Tony
Hawk.
No, yeah, I used to.
Now I don't.
Yeah, me neither, but
I'm stuck in Mexico.
Originally, the movie was supposed to be called The 900. And,
that's interesting.
When Tony didn't make the 900 at the bull ring in August, we had to come up with a new name for the movie, and we just figured that we'll call it The End, since it's the end of Tony. He didn't make the 900.
Hello.
Hello.
That's funny,
but
also
he
made it at a contest.
Where to put Bucky at that point.
Which had more impact.
I had any idea. I didn't know what we were going to do with Bucky, because Tony was such a major part of the film that we can't just throw Bucky in and... You know, we can't just put his part at the beginning of the movie. I'm trying to make sense of the whole thing. We came up with a good idea to have Bucky become this psycho sort of lunatic that around Tony pretended to be his friend, but when he was on his own, he was really frustrated, probably, because
he's
always
so
getting
funny.
Second place, second prize money. Everything was second to Tony. Pairing those guys
that's
wanted
true
to
in
change
the contest
a bunch
and
of times.
Yeah.
They really wanted to not have Bucky have the last part of the movie. I felt the same way, sort of, you know. I really want Tony to have the end part, but I really wanted the movie to have this meaning, and we had shot the bullfighting footage and we had shot, you know, Bucky's psycho footage in mind that Bucky's part was going to end the video. It's like the final payoff for Bucky having the end of the Birdhouse.
Yo, what's up, 720? That was epic. Oh, that was good.